Hey everybody, I'm Philip.
And I'm Justin.
And we are here to give a quick disclaimer on the video that you're about to see of Justin taking the Harvard Music IQ test. We had a lot of technical issues during that with the microphone and the screen capture software. It didn't capture the sound of Justin taking the test. And then the blue snowball we were using was also dealing with some interference. I offered Justin to take the test over again, but in the interest of...
for authenticity, I took the test once. For me to take it a second time, that would give me an unfair advantage, because then I would know what to expect.
So we're going to leave the video intact and the test intact. We're just going to play some nice music while he's taking the test. So enjoy. Hey everybody, I'm Philip.
And I'm Justin.
And together we are pajamas. And I'm really sweaty and gross because everything has gone wrong in like the last 5 minutes. So we're trying to salvage this to make some kind of video together. So today, in today's video, rather, Justin is going to take the Harvard Music IQ test. And then I'll be allowed to post it or not depending on the result.
I don't have a study guide and I'm not sure what kind of test this is. I don't know what to expect.
Right. I do. I've seen a few videos on it. I might take the test after him, just out of curiosity, because I have no musical cognitive ability at all. Like, I'm just musically illiterate. So interesting to see how awful I do. If I get anything right, I'll be happy, pretty much. But this is not about me, it's about you. So let's get started. Go to Google Harvard Music. I can't type. IQ test. All right. Test your musical IQ. Are you a musical prodigy? Find out now. Average time, 21 minutes. So I guess we'll hit play. Go ahead and put on headphones. Make sure they're right. Yeah, this is left ear. Specifically in this research, we are investigating how people make sense of music they hear. We will play you some sounds. You can use speakers or headphones. We'll ask you questions about what you hear. It takes about 20 minutes. This research has no known risks or anticipated direct benefits. After the experiment, we'll explain several ways to be informed about the research. You have any questions? Yada, 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 et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, next. I'm going to try and get comfortable. Okay, so my audio is probably going to be worse now. I'm going to sit here. You can get more comfortable if you like. I'm just going to be a spectator. Think about how you feel while you listen to music. In general, how much do you enjoy music? I enjoy music very much. I don't enjoy music very much. How good do you think your musical listening skills are? I can't talk again. Thank you. So Justin has just completed the three tests, and he's going to answer a few questions before they compute his scores.
Do the best that I could, considering that I could not repeat the score.
Yeah. So Justin's musical IQ is 87.
According to this, most people get in between 85 and 115.
Ah, okay.
So I'm within the range.
Your melodic discrimination is 93. Your beat alignment is 92. Ah, it's the tuning one that got you. 76. Pretty neat. Are you pleased with that?
I'd say I'm so-so about it.
Okay. I mean, you haven't done any music in a long time, so. All right, well, that was Justin taking the Harvard Music IQ test.
Taking it without being able to have the music repeat itself.
Right. So look out for part two to this video coming soon. I don't have a fancy outro, so until the next video, bye.
Goodbye.